swervo, 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 swervo. Yo bitch wanna fuck cause I'm swervo. I drive nuts on swervo.
YouTube, what it do? It's your boy, Mitch, you're always lit. Hey, you already know we always lit. Now I'm back with another video. I said I'm back with another video. Shout out to, what's his name? Shout out to, it's like, at nighttime, it's kind of the lighting is kind of bad, so don't worry about it, but we about to react to, Logan Paul. I'm guessing he came out with this documentary, I guess. This is a random reaction, so yeah. We about to react to, Logan Paul with this. This is gonna be part one. I don't know how long it's gonna be though, but like, yeah, like, comment, subscribe right now. And yeah, it's probably gonna be like 20 minutes. It's gonna be part one, then it's gonna be part two. Then I don't know, like, I've never seen this happen. Like, he never said, oh yeah, trailer, just that and the third one said. I don't follow him on social media, I only follow him on YouTube, and that's it. But, we're gonna get into this video right now, we gotta react to this. This is a random reaction, you know what I mean? It's a random, some random. I just wanna see. I guess this is supposed to be like about his life or whatever. Let's get into the video. Sorry for the lightning, y'all. So, we're gonna get into this video right now. Right to the diggy now. Oh, that's what I wasn't thinking, bro. You know what I mean? But let's get into the video right now. It just came out a couple minutes ago. We only gonna be recording for like 20, 30 minutes. I don't even know. But yeah, let's get into the video right now.
Are you listening? Good. Let me tell you a story.
My name is Logan Paul, and I think I'm coming out of the flat earth closet.
We don't have toilet water flying out of the people in Australia.
Alright, here we go. It feel like... it's finna be a movie in this bit. Here we go. So our first time I actually like
conspiracy
watching
conspiracy theories, you know what I mean? We've all heard them. The legend of Bigfoot, the aliens of Roswell, Area 51, reptilian overlords, you name it. Everywhere you go, there's crazy stories being told. But even crazier, people that actually believe however, this
hold on, y'all. I'll be right back. Sorry about that, y'all. My mom was calling the house phone, and that's what messed up everything. So, yeah, let's get back into the video. It's going to be a few minutes of it playing, but don't worry about it. I'll edit that some kind of way. You know what I mean?
Are you listening? Good. Let me tell you a story.
My name is Logan Paul, and I think I'm coming out of the flat earth closet.
Toilet water flying out of the people in Australia. Conspiracy theories. We've all heard them. The legend of Bigfoot, the aliens of Roswell, Area 51, reptilian overlords, you name it. Everywhere you go, there's crazy stories being told. But even crazier, people that actually believe it. However, this is not one of those conspiracies. My name is Logan Paul. Controversial YouTube star, boxer, ex-vegan, your boyfriend's worst nightmare, and Jake Paul's brother.
That's huge or what?
My whole life, I was taught several irrefutable truths. The sky is blue. Lemurs are native to South Africa. Dogs have tongues that are fully inside their mouths. Well, in most cases. And of course, the earth is round. It started off like any other day, crying in the shower, answering emails and creative differences with my manager, until my good friend Mike challenged one of my deepest beliefs while filming a vlog.
Okay, I didn't pay any ads, you know, the last person to leave this circle wins $200.
How you feeling, Mark?
Water!
What?
Water!
Oh, you know the rules, Mark. No food and water, bro. Come on.
Mark is disqualified, making Evan our winner!
Okay guys, that is it for the video. If you liked it, make sure to give it a big thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, and I will see you next time. Take it easy, fam!
Alright.
That was good.
That was dope.
Solid.
Dope video.
Good stuff,
boys.
Yo, can I talk to you for a sec?
Yeah.
Just, you good?
Yeah. All right.
Hey, did you ever think for a second that, like, the world, the earth, it might be flat?
Hmm?
I don't know, just like all, like, everything that NASA tells us, like, about the earth being round, like, could be just, like, a huge lie, cover up.
What are you saying right now, Doug? Evan is on the verge of death. Yeah?
Yeah. Take care of that for now, and let's talk about it some other time.
Yeah.
Okay, so this seemed a little weird, but then Mike brought it up to me off camera. This is security footage of an actual conversation that took place at 10 p.m.
Hey,
But then I woke up one morning to find this.
Oh, what the heck?
Oh, shit.
Did we get robbed? What's good? What the? Why would someone do this? What the frick, dude? No. Bro, what's good? Why would someone break in and just smash the globes? The northern hemisphere is completely gone. Oh, come on, man. They got glass one too. Bro.
Damn.
This is weird. What happened?
Dude, have you checked the security cameras?
Is that Mike? What the fuck is he doing?
After witnessing my good friend Mike, someone who I've known for years, professional, corporate, level-headed Mike, go on an unprovoked 4 a.m. globe smashing rampage, it finally hit me like a pile of Pangean rocks. Mike is a flat earther.
It's flat, the earth is flat, the man can't use it, it's flat. And how does Mars spin to a ball that spins 1,000 miles an hour?
Anyone ever told you the earth is flat?
Satan's the greatest lie.
Destruction?
This was just the illusion.
The world that we're living in, that we just described.
The north wall, functioning in the center,
and then there's a big ice.
Light travels in the curve from all around the
light of it. I should see that.
Does he really think the earth is flat? Enough was enough.
I was gonna confront Mike once and for all about his interstellar beliefs.
Yo, Mike.
Yeah?
Can I ask you something?
What?
What's your deal, bro? Like, you got something you want to tell me?
I ain't interested in you, butter. I'm sorry, bro. I'll buy more of it.
Nah, it's not about that.
I'm gonna get more of it. Yeah, I told Danny too.
Yeah, it's not about the peanut butter.
What?
I'm gonna say this as a friend, and I need you to be truthful with
what
me.
Is this right now? What are you guys
just
doing?
Listen, I want you to be honest with me. Do you think the Earth is flat?
What are you guys doing right now, seriously?
Can you look at me? Look at me, Mike, please. I need you, as a brother. Do you think the Earth is flat?
So my name is Mike Malak. And when I was younger, my dad used to be a contractor for the U.S. government, Department of Defense. Used to do jobs everywhere, all over the country, internationally. But one of the jobs he got was actually in Antarctica. Occasionally, he would take us on the trips. He'd take my mom and my little sister, and we all went as a family. And he would work during the day. My mom would kind of hang out around the cabin, and there were other families on the base. And we would all just kind of, my sister would play around outside. So we were playing outside, and there were signs everywhere: U.S. government, military, do not pass. So we just kind of did whatever. We like snuck past them, and we're like just walking around, and something like caught my eye. I just kept kind of walking further and further, and that was the first time that I saw it in person.
What did you see?
That was the first time I saw the edge of the Earth. Approached the side and looked over, it was just basically stardust, the cosmos. Just stars as far as the eye could see. I mean, just stunning. And that was the first time, that I really got an understanding. We've been lied to. Kids are, right? And so there's this one kid that I became real, real good friends with. His name was P. He had flat feet, and he kind of hobbled around when he walked. But we struck up this relationship, and he was my best friend. We were just playing, and he was just rolling up another snowball, but he got too close to the side, and I told him, I said, Pete, be careful. All I heard him say was,
when both parties are honest, when there's a foundation of trust.
See that word, by the way, right there, trust, like NASA, for example, like everything they've showed us up until this point, this round Earth from outer space, it's been the same exact picture a million times.
I'm gonna rewind and go back to the relationship stuff that we were talking about.
Well, hold on, let me finish, I'm not done yet. So NASA shows us this picture, it's like a CGI composite of the round Earth, and
can I ask you what you're doing right now, please?
Well, I'm not gonna be a kangaroo with my head in the sand anymore. Come here, I'm gonna show you something right now.
Right now.
Come on.
In the middle of the podcast.
Forget the podcast, we'll do it another time, it's not so live.
This is my shrine. All things flat Earth.
This right here, the new standard map of the world.
This is everything we know about the flat Earth, the ice walls and everything. This is our leader. He wrote this book here, Scientism Exposed. It tells everything about the lies that NASA's been telling us. Never a straight answer. This here is a beach ball. It's a beach ball. And most importantly, the Platypus Kowalski, also known as the extinct human-sized penguin.
You're a fucking idiot, Mike.
Yeah, they feel like, yo, I feel like this is fake.
And Abraham
funny.
Said, eat off my plate, for it is flat, as is the earth. Case closed.
I don't think it is, Mike. I think you're still wrong.
Wrong? Yeah, because I've done years of experiments and scientific research, and I can prove it to you guys right now. Here we have a model of the fantasy world that you two believe exists. If gravity exists the way that you two say it does, and the earth is round, when you're driving your car down the street, how come this doesn't happen? Now, watch this. And now, a flapper, aka reality.
Seems pretty legit. But I wanted to know what the rest of the world thought about this. So I sat down with a select group of highly intelligent elementary students before
oh
I
oh my god, this is funny to me. This shit funny to me.
So I just want to ask you some quick questions here. What's your favorite color?
Purple.
Blue.
Do you have a favorite animal?
A dog. Bird. I love penguins.
I also love penguins. Have you heard of the human-sized penguins? They're extinct now, but they know. What shape is the earth?
Round. Square. A circle.
Do you mean a circle like this? Or a circle like this? Like this. How do you know that?
Because
he's lying.
I'm not lying.
How do you know that?
They can't lie to millions of people.
Seems pretty far-fetched, huh?
What would they... Why... What's the point? What did they get out of it?
What shape is the earth?
Flat.
Who told you the earth was flat?
The earth's flat because if it wasn't flat, then we would all be falling off of it.
Does that upset you?
Yes.
What would happen if you were walking one day and you found yourself falling into a deep abyss?
Well, I guess that's just the end of my life.
The child had a good point. This was slowly becoming a puzzle that not even I, the all-knowing and error-free Logan Paul, could solve. Until I found out about this.
This is a day that's going to be best in history. Quest for truth, and it can seem crazy, but all of us laughed at this topic, including myself. This is probably the most ridiculous thing I ever thought that I'd be doing, and here I am organizing the Flat Earth International Conference, but I'm not laughing anymore.
Two words. There's no other two words that bring the reactions that these two words bring. And those two words put together are flat earth.
So much knowledge, all in one place. I knew I had to attend. I packed up all my bags, grabbed all of Team Maverick, and got on the plane to Denver, Colorado for the 2018 International Flat Earth Conference.
Robbie Davidson, the CEO and founder of the Flat Earth.
Robbie?
Yeah.
Robbie Davidson.
Do you know Robbie Davidson?
Do you know who that is?
I know.
That's the guy from my wall.
Yeah,
I've been following him for years, Bobby's book. If you guys have to put yourselves in my shoes for a second, just to understand, like, what this means.
I'm so happy that you guys came, bud.
What's up, Logan? How are you?
Good, man.
Nice to meet you. That's my friend, Mike.
Hey, what's up, bro? Mike, nice to meet you again, Mike.
Dude, it's gonna rock your mind, man. It's gonna blow your mind.
I'm ready. That's what I want. Ask all the hard questions to everyone.
Man, they're gonna, like, just love the fact that you're just open.
Awesome, man.
Thank you.
How you feel?
So crazy, bro.
Yo, you fanboy.
I was up there looking down at Earth thinking, everybody I know lives there, and everybody they know have known.
Do you hear this?
All shares.
That's a NASA astronaut. He's been to space. There's a picture.
Bro,
he took that selfie.
Bro, that is literally the exact same thing as a Hollywood production.
Explain this. This is an image of the planet.
Oh, literally, like... You follow Instagram girls on Instagram, obviously, models, bro, who use Facetune on their face, like, and their
body. They use Facetune on the planet Earth?
It's like a composite, dude. Like a composite. Built to continue to, like, push their narrative, bro.
Alright.
Absolutely incredible. I remember a year ago I said the same thing, but now we've taken it to the next level. It's unbelievable to me that in 2018 this many people can start questioning the reality of where they live. But the reality is this: the truth sets you free. And we want to be set free. So with that, I want to introduce the Master of Ceremonies again for the Third Flat Earth International Conference, Mr. Rick Hummer.
Hummer, Hummer.
I'm not ashamed to say there's bubbles in space. I'm not ashamed to say they lost all the data to the moon missions. I'm not ashamed to say that water's a natural level. I'm not ashamed and to say that gravity is still only a theory, and that buoyancy and density still hold on. I'm not ashamed to say that Brian Cox, Neil deGrasse Tyson, Bill Nye, Elon Musk, and the likes of them are not as smart as they think they are.
I'm not ashamed.
Flat!
They made some good points. I'm still skeptical.
I mean, at least you're opening up, though, at least.
I wouldn't say that.
I came to the idea of Flat Earth in the beginning of 2015, so when I watched my first, it was a 6-hour presentation, so it gave me a lot of information about
sure,
it.
Sure, way more than, like, the sentence.
Way more than I needed.
Yeah, how's it going?
That's kind of young to be a Flat Earther.
I mean, it's facts. Like, I can think of myself. I'm almost 15.
Oh, man.
When people call you,
crazy or whatever. Like, what do you say to them?
I don't really feel like I have to defend myself.
Millions and millions of people that are now questioning everything space agencies have been showing us. Why is that?
If NASA would lie, like, about the globe and, like, about the moon landing and stuff, then what else would everyone lie about?
Have you seen Jurassic World?
Yes.
And the Universal logo is when they...
Is it a paintball at the beginning?
How is that shot?
They're either composites or, you know, animations or artistic renderings, et cetera, et cetera.
Like they can...
Yes.
My dad has always been a truth seeker, right? He's been telling me since I was little kids that we didn't go to the moon. He knew about 9/11 right away.
He knew about 9/11?
Like, that it was not... the real story, the man was a genius. So we're in my room and he like passed me on the shoulder. Oh yeah, by the way, the earth is flat.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm like, okay, whatever.
So you don't believe in the globe?
It's not that I don't believe in the globe. I absolutely know that we don't live on a spinning globe.
You know it.
There's no
so let me ask you this.
Life.
The fact that I'm drinking out of a cylindrical cup with a world map on it, does that upset you?
Sure.
It didn't make sense to me. It didn't make sense how we didn't fly off or how the water... the ball.
My friend actually conducted an experiment where he like blew up the globe and then he drove an RC car off.
Right, why aren't we flying off?
Do you acknowledge that other planets are around?
I don't acknowledge that other planets are planets. We don't live on a planet, we live on a plane. What we see in the sky are just little lights. They're very close. The only pictures you see of the planets come from two sources. One is NASA and the other one is Disney. And at this point, Disney's more credible than NASA.
My brother was on a Disney show. Got fired. So that just, I mean, to me, that proves, like, there's something going on.
Don't laugh at this, you know? You're either, you laugh at this confirmation without investigation. It's confirmation of your indoctrination.
Probably worth it, right?
Yeah, yeah. And it makes total sense to write that down.
Flat Earth affects every single person every day. It's the biggest market of anything. So we don't even have a real picture of the globe.
So I don't have a picture of my intestines, but I know they exist.
Earth is flat. Neil deGrasse can't debate these facts if he wanted to. Earth is flat and stationary, bro. That means it doesn't move. When confronted with the brute, liars get uncomfortable.
This guy shot himself out of a rocket by himself without medicine. This is incredible.
I say, flat disc. I did it.
Okay, well, why did you do that? Did you really be done? You're a maverick. We gotta get you some merch.
NASA's been tricking us all. Gravity isn't the law. Ha! Ha! You're holding down this board. Think you should get on a call.
Are you a flat earther?
I am indeed.
Is your dog a flat earther?
She is. By the way, if you guys can obscure my face, I'd appreciate it.
Oh, that's cool. Oh, yeah.
I work for space systems around Palo Alto, California. We were launching ICBM. They're just keeping this all a secret because they don't want people to know to launch a nuke, right?
So you got one of Satan's devices
right there, right there.
But what about like the NASA moon landings and astronauts?
Bang.
Say that, but I've seen you in space.
I don't recall.
So your dad's a flat earther?
Yeah.
What do you think of your dad?
I don't know.
Do you still love him?
Oh, yeah.
That's good. It's good that you still love your family, even though he's a flat earther.
I mean, yeah.
Have you ever considered not loving him?
Nothing says flat earth or I understand my theory like wind chimes, mirrors with a Santa hat on top of it.
Yeah.
This dude, to me, is the epitome of knowledge.
Okay.
So I think we should follow
him. Okay. You're a flat earther.
Yes.
Hardcore.
Totally. I'm all in. You don't feel yourself spinning, wobbling, or gyrating, do you? We don't have toilet water flying out on people in Australia because of gravity. Well, hello, it's just water seeking its level. That's what it does.
Complete the following song lyric. The wheels on the bus go
round and round, round and round, round
but,
and round.
But the earth isn't round.
True.
So you say. The wheels on the bus go
round and round. Hello.
Hi. And I think there's definitely more flat earthers around the globe than we think.
Around the what?
The globe.
The globe. Well, everybody's around the globe. The globe's in your mind. Your mind, my mind. Even though I know we don't live on a globe, I know that the globe exists. Well, so here's the deal. I thought I was born again over 30 years ago until I actually was 4 years ago. Now I get to do what I want. I tried pleasing others. I tried to please friends, family. I tried pleasing myself.
Are you talking about masturbation?
Yeah.
Don't mind if I do. Come on. Hey guys.
Hi.
Are you guys flat earthers?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Are you?
Really?
Sorry about the giant cameras in your
face. Yeah, what's going on, you guys?
We're shooting a documentary.
Oh, you are? That's cool.
Yeah. You have an accent?
Yeah.
Where are you from?
Australia.
My friend is a flat earther too.
Hi.
Yeah, nice to meet you.
Hi.
Nice to meet you. Cool. You're out here as like a joke?
No. I live in Australia, so like.
Well, and you flew here just for this?
Well, I live in LA now, but she's listening, so it's about.
That's cool. Alright, so like, alright, can I ask you like, why you think the earth is flat?
Yeah. The other reason people like think that it's round is because like you shake your eyes around.
Oh.
Straight.
Oh.
Yeah.
That's why you're so pretty. I'm getting nervous.
Yeah, I guess cut.
But.
He's smitten
as hell, dude. He really is, dude. Like, just like hot girls in general, but she's got these, like, eyes, dude. And I know how he is like when it comes to girls with eyes like that, bro.
Bye, guys.
Holy shit, dude. I asked her to dinner. I'm going on a date with a flat earth girl.
Yo, I wonder if she'll order the flatbread. Oh!
Robbie.
You're famous around here. So what, in your opinion, is the most damning piece of scientific evidence?
When you're taught that you just came from nothing, because the scientific narrative is nothing exploded and created everything. Mm-hmm. And we're crazy. They'd rather believe that nothing created all this. When all of a sudden you start looking into the fact that maybe everything in the sky was put in place for us, there's value. Maybe there's something out there that's actually watching over top of us.
Are you saying we could be like specimens in a petri dish?
I personally believe that, yes, the creator is looking right down on us. The sun, moon, and stars were placed in the firmament. And again, what it says, biblically speaking, they're just lights, dude. They're lights. And yes, the moon. And here's a startling thing. We believe the sun and the moon are the same size, just like they appear in the sky.
Really?
They say, oh, they're further away, millions of miles. They're the same, man. They're both lights. They do different things, but they're the same size.
Whoa.
I know.
The Edge.
Okay.
Have you seen it?
You can get it booked. Get down there. They're going to take a picture with a penguin. They'll take you to a ceremonial pole. But you say, hey, dude, I want to grab a backpack. I want to go explore. You won't be allowed.
Really?
It is guarded big time. 40 countries signed a peace treaty, and it's the longest standing peace treaty that no one's ever broken. And it says that only military and science can go there. You're not allowed to go backpack.
Side note, in the ancient, like Jurassic times, there were penguins the size of humans.
Absolutely.
Man, I'm sitting here and I'm kind of under the mindset of like, what if they're right? What if?
But it is scary if you think that everything you thought was true was a lie. It is frightening. It's frightening. So I hear you, man. I hear you.
Man, Robbie, I just don't know what to believe anymore. Hi.
Hey.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
Good. I got you these flowers.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, they're fake.
Yeah, that's fine. Okay.
Is this us?
Yeah, I think so.
No, I got it. Oh, okay. Here you go.
Thank you.
Applebee's in Australia.
I think so.
Well, welcome to the beautiful restaurant of Applebee's. I'm from Ohio, so it's kind of like a delicacy.
Is it?
Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah, I love your accent, by the way.
You do?
I love it.
It sounds like you have an accent, not me.
I have an accent.
Is that what it sounds like?
I can talk Australian.
Really?
Shrimp on the barbie.
Wait, anyone call the street? We'll have problems.
Yo. Hope y'all enjoyed this video, man. Like, comment, subscribe. It's almost over. We're almost over with this bit, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, part two coming up tomorrow. I wanna get this video before.
I'm on a new level.
So, I'm on a new level.
I'm on a new level.
Was at 31.
I'm on a new level.
31.
Put me a new shovel.
I'm
a nigga, put a book. I'm on a new level. 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 Bought me a new shovel.
Love y'all so much. Put these niggas in the dirt. Yeah.
Change with the new bezel. Oh, my nigga put a work. Used to be sleeping on itchy beds. Bad buds in the motel. Now your bitch give me head. 20 bitches in the hotel. Hunter Roman noodle diet.